Hello and welcome to SkyFactory 4. My name is Whisperfire and today I want to make preparations to go into the Lost Cities. But to do that, I figured that it would make life a lot easier if we had a digital miner. So that's our goal for today, is we're going to make a digital miner from scratch. So I got the storage request table. And the first thing that we're going to do is get some iron amber. So I discovered that if we get a stack of iron amber and 4 stacks of coal, all right, we'll grab 4 stacks of coal. And if we put it into the smelter here, this will mix together. We have to have it wait for a moment. And it will mix and make steel. So I've already made some steel in preparation of making some of these mechanism machines. So we'll just go ahead and let that cook for a little bit. And off camera, I set up a flux network with a integrated dynamics power cell or energy battery so that we have some power storage. So it's nothing special. It's just something hooked up to our generators, so that we can transfer power wirelessly across dimensions. Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna need is a couple of metallurgic infusers. So we'll go ahead, grab that, and grab a GPS. Okay, we're gonna grab 2 of these GPS. We're gonna use up the cyclic. Okay, and then we're eventually going to need to make an osmium compressor and I believe an enrichment chamber. I'm not too sure about this. This may not be necessary, but to get the digital miner, we need to get atomic alloys, teleportation cores, a robot, a steel casing, and all that fun stuff. So let's see, we're going to need some circuits to get started. So to refresh my memory, we're going to need basic control circuits, which is redstone and osmium. Okay, so I'm going to grab some redstone and we're going to grab a stack of that and we're going to grab another stack of that. Yeah, and some osmium. So we're going to grab a stack of osmium and a stack of iron. So we're going to go ahead and get these circuits all made in advance. So let's see where to put it. I guess right here will work fine. Okay, so we got our GPS markers and we're going to take that, put it in separate inventories, shift right click and shift right click, and we're going to put it into the energy transfer node. So that should transfer enough power to these metallurgic infusers. So we'll put redstone in this one and iron so that it can make the atomic alloy, and this to make the other circuits, which is, I believe, basic control circuits. Okay, so we gotta sit and wait for this to cook for a little bit. Let's go ahead and look up speed upgrades. And you know what? I just noticed these don't make a sound. I guess the config has been tweaked so that we don't have to worry about sound upgrades. That's pretty convenient. Yeah, that is pretty convenient. So let's go ahead and look up speed upgrades. All right, what do we need for speed upgrade? Okay, we're going to need some osmium dust. How do we make osmium dust? The enrichment chamber. Okay, so for the sake of making the upgrades, because I think under Age of Power, right? No, Age of Enchantment, we gotta make a speed upgrade, a muffling upgrade, and a energy upgrade. That should be easy. You know what? Let's see if we can get this enchanting table out of the way. I did it before. An enchanting table. We should be able to do it. We need a book. All right, we're going to need 2 patterns. So let's go ahead and grab 2 of these blank patterns. Basically, we're just doing something to kill the time while we're waiting for everything to process. So we got ourselves a book and got ourselves an enchanting table. And we'll just dump it in here for now. Okay, we don't have any poisoned potatoes just yet. I've been working on the potato farm, and each of these require poisoned potatoes. And these are nuclear craft upgrades, but we're almost done with the Age of Enchantment, which I am quite pleased with. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at our upgrades. All right, that is still cooking. I will get right back with you after we made a couple circuits to start on our next step. A couple things happened in between cuts. First off, in real life, a construction crew decided to park itself outside the house and decide to dig a swimming pool for the neighbor. So that meant that I couldn't record for several hours because it made too much noise. So I figured turn that lemon into lemonade and use the time to grind all of these enriched alloys and circuits. And eventually I made my way all the way up to the ultimate control circuit. Now this may be overkill, but I looked ahead and thought about how to power this digital miner that we're planning to build. And for some reason, I can't seem to get the Flux network to work. I got it plugged into an energy battery by Integrated Dynamics. I got a Flux controller and a Flux plug, which adds power to the network. But it's not transferring any power. It's not registering any power. And any Flux plugs that I've put in just seem to not work. Also, I did away with the wireless GPS for Cyclic and just simply made the Cyclic energy cable, made more metallurgic infusers, a crusher, and an enrichment chamber. So I kind of expanded on the project of making all of those circuits and alloys. So the next step for our digital miner is that we need an osmium compressor. And let me show you the recipe for the wind generator. It's actually going to take a wind turbine blade and that ultimate control circuit, which was really hard to make, plus this advanced energy cube. So this recipe has gotten pretty expensive. So this is going to be an alternative way of powering the digital miner when we get around to use it. And I made some preparations so that we can make the speed upgrade, the energy upgrade, and the muffling upgrade. So we got these three upgrades. Let's take a look at our advancements. I think it's under Age of Power or Enchantment. Yes, these three here. We got these three enchantments. So still waiting on the poison potatoes, so I gotta work on that potato farm. And then we got some upgrades from Nuclear Craft, and we can actually write this as done. Okay, so I'll make more as we need them, but for now, we're gonna work on the digital miner. So we're gonna need the steel casing, and as I explained earlier, we made steel by mixing iron amber and coal and let it mix in the alloy furnace. Wow, I can words today. Yeah, I can really, really words today. Okay, we need two teleportation cores, and I don't think they stack. Oh, they do. Okay, and let's see. What else do we need? We're going to need this logistical sorter. So we're going to need two pistons. That's easy. Okay, two pistons. One and two. Okay, then let's see, we're gonna need a robot. So this is gonna take a little bit of advanced crafting. We're gonna need to make refined osmium ingots. How do we do that? We need the osmium compressor. So let's go ahead and make ourselves the osmium compressor. And let's see, let's look into our chest. We got some pulverized obsidian and we got some of this compressed diamond. I know, I made too much. I thought that this was a ratio of 1 to 1. Turned out it's 1 to 8. So we just need 8 of these per stack. And that should take care of it for our enriched obsidian. So we'll go ahead and let this cook for a little bit. So we'll go ahead, to our metallurgic infuser, put 8 in there, 8 in there, 8 in a stack, and then we take our osmium compressor. We're going to need some osmium for that. Okay. Doop a doop a doop a doop a doop a doop a doop. Osmium. Alright, we got ourselves some osmium. And let's take a look for the refined obsidian ingot. Yeah, we needed the refined obsidian dust and the osmium ingot. So we'll go ahead and put the osmium in there. Doop a doop a doop a doop. Oh, yes. Something else happened in between cuts. The server died. Yeah, the server actually died. It was linked to some ME power cells. I had to ask Jam Doggy and Family Craft Dad to help me troubleshoot the issue. So it turned out to be ME power cells that was within a chunk loader, the Weird Engadget. So we had to institute a new rule that, we had to also break the ME power cells, but no one on the server can use weirding gadgets. So no more chunk loaders. I had to get rid of mine. I has a sad. But the server is still going. It is still going. So I wanted to thank Jam Doggy and FCD, Family Craft Dad, for helping me admin the server, because this is troubleshooting a modded server is a little bit beyond my skill set. But I am learning, and it's been definitely quite an experience. And I am happy that people are using the server. Just, they're going to extremes. They're getting too OP. It's giving it all she's got, Captain. Okay, I'll stop. Okay, so... okay, so we'll work on the robot, and we're gonna need this personal chest. That should be easy. We got the personal chest. Okay, and what else for the robot? We're gonna need 2 energy tablets. Alright, I know for a fact these don't stack. Okay, so all we need to do is come over here and we'll grab the first of the obsidian, the enriched obsidian or refined obsidian, and we'll put it in the osmium compressor. We're just gonna need 2, so we're gonna sit here and wait. Doop, doop, doop. While we're waiting, I put together a wish list of mystical agriculture seeds that I wanted to make, like tritanium, uranium, thorium, boron, lithium, magnesium, and then also from astral sorcery. Oh yeah, also dilithium, but also from astral sorcery, rock crystal, star metal, and aquamarine. Jam Doggy has actually made all of these seeds, so I could actually harvest off him. In fact, if you take a look at this journey map screenshot that he took, he has already explored the Forgotten City's realm, so there may not be much for us once we get there. But I am holding out hope that it's still there. So, we'll go ahead and now we're gonna make ourselves a robot. Okay, what are we missing? Alright, we need that personal chest. So, just put that personal chest right here. We got ourselves a robot. And then, boom, the digital miner. What are we missing? The logistical transporters. Alright, logistical transporters. And what else are we missing? We're missing another steel casing. Okay, we must have used it when we made the osmium compressor. Alright, so, boom, and boom. Oh, this is a wonderful machine. This is so wonderful. We'll go ahead and place it here for now so that we can pre-program it and update it. So let's go ahead and get all of those upgrades. I don't think it's gonna need a muffling upgrade, but it sure as heck gonna need the speed and the energy upgrade. So we'll go ahead and make 7 more of these. All right, that should make it 8. And then 7 more energy upgrades. All right, so that should do it. Now there's another upgrade that I want, and that's the anchor upgrade, which should keep it loaded. So we're gonna need some diamond dust. So we're gonna need diamond. So I think we just need 1, so that should be fine. Yes, I am happy because I just had coffee. It's first thing in the morning. I am actually recording it on Friday morning. This video will come out later this afternoon. So I had a good night's sleep and a big old thing of coffee. So I am a little bit hyper, so don't mind me. Oh, it's so nice. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and grab our crushed diamond dust and we're going to grab our anchor upgrade. Okay. And then we're going to make some windmills. Okay, so that should do it. And we'll go back here. Mechanism and the anchor upgrade. All right. Doop a doop a doop a boop a doop a doop. Yeah, I know. I'm a little bit too hyper. Okay, so that should get the upgrades that we need. All right, let's go ahead and work on the power because, yeah, I just couldn't figure out how to get the flux network to work. So either they changed it or I am a complete doofus. I don't know. I think I'm willing to refer to being a complete doofus. All right, so about how many wind generators do we need? I think 8. Yeah, let's make 8. Do these stack? Yes, they do. All right, so we'll go ahead and make this. That's 6 and that's 8. We're going to be making 8 of these. I think that's a good start. So we're going to need advanced energy cables, which means basic energy cubes. So we're going to need 8 of these. It's a good thing that I had the time on my hands to make this in bulk. So we're going to need 16 of these energy tablets. And yeah, the frustrating part with this is that it doesn't stack. So we'll just go ahead and make 16 of these bad boys. Yep. I know. Still crafting, but the simple crafting network has made things a lot easier. So we'll just go ahead and pop it in there. Okay. Next. All right. So we're going to need 8 of these. And they don't stack. Who would have thunk it? All right. We'll go ahead and put these basic energy cores back in here. Okay. And that should be it, right? Oh, we need to manually put these in. Okay. So, are you going to... Oh, these are basic energy cubes. We need to go one more step. We need to make another 16 energy tablets. Yeah. It's a good thing that before the ban on chunk loaders, this thing was chunk loaded. So I have all of the resources that I need. I actually don't think I'd be able to achieve this many resources if this was a single player world because I would have had to sit AFK and let this run. So I am grateful for the time that we had with our chunk loaders, you know? So we'll go ahead and make some advanced energy cubes. All right, so we're gonna make 8 of these. All right, we need one more. Boom. All right, 8 advanced energy cubes. Okay, give me 8 wind generators. Yes, wind generators, come here, come to Butthead. You are beautiful. I love these things. And there we go. I was missing one. So we got ourselves some advanced wind generators. Okay, now let's go ahead and go into cyclic because Jamdoggy made an observation that the tubing from mechanism, like the universal cables or the mechanized pipes for fluids have been disabled. In fact, anything for gas and temperature are enabled. Everything else is disabled. So we're going to have to use alternative piping. And so far, I've been finding that Cyclic has been playing relatively nice with the mechanism. So we're going to go ahead and make some Cyclic pipes. All right, so this is all preparation. What do you know? We got the energy extraction cables here. We don't need to craft it. and we got ourselves a stack. This should do it. Okay. You know what? We're gonna need a backpack. Yeah, we're gonna need a backpack. And I know this thing makes a backpack. But let's see. How big can we do it? All right, 4 leather, a stack, and 36. Let's make ourselves a backpack. Okay, plastic. All right, we'll just grab a stack. Iron, grab a stack of that. Leather. All right, we'll just grab what we have. And what else did we need? We need a defense. So we don't have that, but all right, and we'll just, now that's diagonal, we'll just grab this one left over. All right, so we'll go ahead and just get ready for appropriations, and this should do it. And it's red. You know what? I don't mind. I don't mind at all. So let's take a look at our backpack. Boom! That is big. So we'll go ahead and put all of our stuff in there. We got ourselves a backpack. Go ahead and put this back. And next is the fun part. We're going to make the cake. And we're not just going to make an Overcity, a Lost Cities cake. We're going to make all of the cakes and take a peek at the dimensions, okay? So we'll go ahead, type in cake. We already have the nether cake. We're going to need the end cake. So got that. And we got ourselves an end cake. We're going to make a Twilight Forest cake. We're going to go ahead and take a peek in these dimensions. And last but not least, the Lost Cities cake. So we got the rest of our cakes. All right, so we'll go ahead and place these down. Doop a doop a doop a bump, bump, and bump. Okay, and if we're going to another dimension, let's go ahead and grab our, let's grab the red armor. Yeah, let's grab the red armor. Let's go ahead and look through all of this. Where are the boots? Where are those boots? Yeah, it's here somewhere. Ah, there it is. All right, we'll just go ahead and put this on. It gives us a little extra armor. And yeah. Okay, so let's look at the cake. It should be under Age of Exploration. Okay. So we got the end cake. All right, so we'll check out the Twilight Forest just to take a peek. And we'll check out the end just to take a peek, okay? So it looks like we're going to enter another dimension and enter the end biome. All right, let's check out the end just for kicks. Okay, this has already been scouted out before by other people on the server. And it looks like someone left the portal here. Okay, so, and it looks, oh, excuse me, I got the hiccups. All right, we'll go ahead and put our cake there. And it looks like people have fought the end dragon a couple of times. So, that's all there's to it. There's no end dragon, but you can summon the end dragon and you can go into the cities. Let's go ahead and take advantage. We'll go ahead and grab ourselves some more end stone. I think that should do it. And we're going to go ahead and go for the ultra noms. Oh yes, I got the gluttony charm. I got that while we were fighting the mobs and the deep mob learning, because it's just, it makes things easier. All right, so we just visited the end, and what screen is this? Oh, it's the end screen. Okay, yay, technically we beat the game. Whoopee! Okay, now let's go ahead and check out the Twilight Forest. Yeah, now the Twilight Forest is a little bit different. It's actually Sky Islands. Yeah, it's actually Sky Island. So we'll go ahead and put a thing here. Okay, so yeah, it's just a series of Sky Islands, and it's just a Twilight Forest. We've already been to the Twilight Forest in, like, the last two packs. In fact, we went over it with War Cookie. Teaching her the Twilight Forest, we've actually beaten it. Went up to the end boss to find out that the mod was incomplete. So, yeah. We'll go ahead and check it out. We're just simply scoping it out and heading back here. Okay, so we're heading back. And we visited the Twilight Forest. So let's take a look. The last dimension that we're going to is the Lost Cities. And that is going to be the subject of our next episode. Going into the Lost Cities so that we can get these ores here. That's why I got the silk touch, because things like dilithium breaks down kind of like diamonds do, like from ore to the actual item. So we needed the block so that we can program the digital miner to take care of it. And we got ourselves a power supply. We got our upgrades in. I think we are all set. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this episode. It's been full of derps, but we got the end goal. We got the digital miner. We got it upgraded. We got a power supply ready. So all we need to do is spend some time in the Lost Cities to get the ores, and maybe we can get into nuclear craft. The last time I've been in nuclear craft was back in Atom Smasher. It was a pack made by Landstrider, and he taught me how to make a 5x5x3 reactor. Which, our power supply is actually, it's derpy, but it works. So, it works for our needs, so we don't need any more power. But, I still want to get into nuclear craft because it's cool. It's shiny. So, anyway, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh, yeah.